Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about distributed lock using Zookeeper. Now, what is distributed lock? In simple term, distributed lock means that only one of the servers will be able to access a particular resource at a particular time. If there are multiple servers trying to access a particular resource, then only one of those will be able to access it and others will be denied. And then later they can retry if they want to, or they can choose not to even retry. So that's the distributed lock, and this is being used heavily in the distributed world because at times you want to access a particular resource, and to do that you would need to take a lock. Now there are multiple approaches to take the distributed lock, and Zookeeper is just one of those. It is also heavily used and very common. And using the concept of Zookeeper data modeling, we'll see how in a very simple modeling method, we can take the advantage of distributed locks. So let's quickly get started. I have three servers here, server 1, server 2 and server 3. And this is the clear-cut requirement which I have, that only one server should have access to the log and other server should wait. So I'm taking the option of waiting. You can choose not to have the option of waiting and just end your attempt there itself. But I'm taking a step ahead and trying to have a concept of waiting as well. And if a server leaves a lock, then the other server should acquire the lock. So let's say server 1, 2 and 3, all of these were trying to get the lock on a particular resource. So let's say server 1 was able to get the lock. Then server 2 and 3 will keep on waiting for server 1 to finish. Then server 2 or server 3, either of the two will get the lock, and then eventually server 3 would get the lock. So in this way, at a time only one of the servers will be able to get the access to the resource. So this is the overall requirement which we are going to cater using Zookeeper. Now, I quickly want to help you recap what is the node structure of Zookeeper. You can in fact refer to the Zookeeper data modeling video in this particular playlist and you will understand it even better. So this is the node structure or the Zookeeper data model which we are going to use here, that we'll create a node called as /locks in the Zookeeper tree, and then within that tree will have multiple child, that is /locks/lock0/lock/1 and 2. So we'll have multiple children, and this will be created using ephemeral sequential node. Now if you are not able to recall what are these things, please go back and see the video on the data modeling concepts of Zookeeper. I'll link the video in the description. So what happens is that all these clients, the client 1 or the server 1, server 2 and server 3, will try to create the ephemeral sequential node, and Zookeeper will make sure that these numbers 0, 1 and 2 are unique and increasing. So if the first server goes here and tries to create a node under the /locks table, Zookeeper will make sure that the first person or the first server who makes this request will be able to create /lock/0. The second will be /lock/1 and the third will be /2. So in this way, different nodes will be created, and then we will leverage this concept. So this is the overall summary or the recap of what we are going to do, or what is the approach which we are going to take. So now let me quickly move on to the algorithm part so that you have idea that what we are going to see here, and then we'll move on to the code part as well. So that's the eventual goal, to run a code and see how the whole approach of the distributed lock looks like. So if you see here that this is the start, and then each server, when it comes to life or when it tries to get a lock, it will create a ephemeral sequential node under this path, /locks/ lock hyphen. So you can have anything you want, but this is the pattern I'm going to follow. Slash locks slash, and data will be its own ID. So let's say there are three servers running. So server one can have data equal to server one. Server two can have data equal to server two. And the server three can have data equal to server three. So if you see that the Zookeeper data model, each node in that tree will have a path, which will be from the root node till the leaf node. And each node will have the data. Now, each of the servers will create this and Zookeeper will assign a value to it. So when you create a node called as slash logs slash log hyphen, then Zookeeper will assign hyphen zero. Now the second server, when it makes the request, it will be assigned hyphen one, and the third one will be assigned hyphen two. So the one with the minimum or the smallest sequence number will get the lock. This is the consensus which you have built among the servers, that whichever has the smallest sequence number will get the lock. And if I'm not the smallest one, then I will have to wait. So this server will now check that whatever lock or whatever children I'm getting under the particular root node, am I the smallest one or not? If I'm the smallest one, I'll acquire the lock. And if I'm not the smallest one, then what I'll do is I'll watch or I will wait for the other node to be deleted so that I can acquire the lock. So if I come back to the tree to give you some idea, so what will happen is that first server will create slash lock slash zero. So I'm taking the simple example of 0, 1 and 2. There is a bit of padding also involved here. That is, it's not exactly 0, it's 0, 0, 0, 0. It's not exactly 1, it is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So likewise, there is some padding, but for the simplicity, it's one and the same thing. So you create this node and these are ephemeral nodes. That is, the moment the server which has taken the lock, that is done with its job, it will delete this particular node. Or if the server which has taken the lock, it dies, then this node automatically will be deleted. So there are two types of node, ephemeral and permanent. Permanent never gets deleted even if the client dies, but the ephemeral gets deleted if the client dies, and or if the connection is lost between the client and the server and the server thinks that the client is dead. In those cases, this node will die. And the second server which has this particular node created, this will be the smallest one. And now since this is the smallest one, this will be the master. And the third one, when this one is also done with its work, it will itself delete this node. Or if it does not delete the node itself, or let's say this server dies, then this will be deleted by the Zookeeper server, and then this will become the master. So the crux is that the smallest one will be the master, so that if the new node gets added, it will be assigned a higher number, that is hyphen 3. And likewise, you can keep on having the new lock taking server. So that's the overall idea. And now we can quickly move on to the coding and see how the overall code looks like. The code for the distributed lock is very simple. I will still link the code in the description, the GitHub repo, but let me just go through it nevertheless. The only dependency you need is the Apache Zookeeper dependency in your Java project. And then I have only one class, that is locks, because that's what I'm going to demo and show you here. And this is the overall code. So what I have done is that I have created a watcher. Watcher means that it will watch for any changes happening in the node, because that's what we want, right? That whenever a particular node is deleted, so there were three nodes, node 1, node 2, node 3, or node 0, node 1, node 2. So if 0 gets deleted, the 1 and the 2 should come to know that which one has got deleted, so that they can choose a new master or the new server who has the lock. So this is what we have done, that we have created a watcher, that is the event-based programming. Again, I will link this in the description on how to interact with Zookeeper using Java and Maven project. It's fairly straightforward again. So here, that's what we have done, that we have an event listener on the node children changed. And whenever a node children gets changed, we try to either get a lock because a node has changed, or if we are not able to get the lock, we wait to get the lock. That is, if we are first in the queue, then we take the lock. And if we are second in the queue or third in the queue, then we wait for our turn. Here we are doing nothing but connecting to the Zookeeper server. I have set up my Zookeeper on local in localhost 2181. It's again a syntactical stuff. I'm creating a root node here, which for the first time you would need to do. That is the root node equal to /roots or /locks. And then here I'm creating a ephemeral sequential node so that it gets assigned a sequence number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then this is where I'm trying to get the lock or wait for it. So the way I do is that I get the list of children and then I sort the list of children. So let's say I get lock-0, lock-1, lock-2. So I just get the 0th index of the children. And then what I do is that I just compare that whether this particular node was created by me or not. So here I'm creating a node, and then here I'm just checking that whatever node I created, is this the smallest node or not? If it is smallest, then I acquire the lock. And for the demo purpose, I have said that for 10 seconds, I will acquire the lock and then I'll no longer need the lock. So basically, I'll delete my node. And that's it. My code will end here. So for the more sophisticated purposes, you can have more interesting code. But for me, the sleep stuff works. And if I'm not able to get the lock, that is the smallest node is not the node which was created by me, then what I do is I create a listener, that is watch equal to true on the particular node, so that whenever the node changes, I will again check is the smallest node equal to the node created by me. So very simple code. This is what is happening here. And what I'll do is I'll open the terminal and run three different servers, basically three different terminals. And then I will launch the terminals so that you can see that when did the first one got the lock, when did the second one got the lock, and when did the third one got the lock. So let me quickly get started with that. Here I have opened three different terminals. You can imagine each terminal or the each process running in different machine so that they are trying to take the lock. This is the command to run the Maven based project. You can have even more sophisticated ways of running the code, but for me this works. So I have put this code here, here and here. I'll put this particular command in my GitHub repo as well. You can check out. And if I run the first one, now let's see what happens. You can see it acquired the lock and it will leave the lock in next 10 seconds. And you can see here, it is the second one is waiting to get the lock. The moment the first one finished, the second one got the lock. And the third one, if I trigger here, you can see the third one is waiting for the lock. And the moment the second one is finished, the third one got the lock. So very simple example that you launch a server and the one which is the first one that gets the lock, the other servers just keep on waiting. Extremely simple example to visualize what Zookeeper can do and the way Zookeeper helps you in having the distributed locks. Thank you very much for watching the video. I hope this video would have given you some idea on how the distributed lock work in context of Zookeeper and how smartly we can use the Zookeeper server to implement the Zookeeper lock. Remember, we didn't have to do anything on the server. The only thing we did on the server was to launch it, and then it was on the client to use it in a way that it satisfies the use case of distributed lock. So this is the very interesting thing, that the simple Zookeeper data model helps us to solve so many problems. I'll keep on posting such videos every week. Till the next time, bye.